This is a song about the show Felta. People tell true stories and the puppets act them out. And that's pretty much what the show is all about. Yeah, this is the show Felta.
Felta!
Simon asked me to write the theme song, the kind that gets you pumped and makes you want to sing along. But I had a lot of other things going on, so I'll just say the words felt up.
Felt up!
Felt up.
Change of plans, you guys. The theme of today's episode is no longer Curse of the X. Instead, the theme is, do my ex-girlfriends even still think that I'm cool at all still? As such, I've invited three of my exes for sit-down interviews. So, Sam, do you even still think that I'm cool still?
Why would you even ask that?
It's a silly question, isn't it? Silly because it's obviously yes or no.
Why do you care? Haven't you moved on?
Yes.
Look, Simon, this is exactly why I dumped you. You were so dependent on what other people thought of you.
Do you feel that a lot of people think that about me?
You could never stick with anything. You took up hobby after hobby and then abandoned them when they got too hard or you found something you were more interested in.
I didn't even give up on any of them, Melissa. I was diversifying my hobby portfolio.
So you're still cobbling?
Depends how often my sneakers rip.
I can't see your elliptical around here.
Have you seen my calf muscles recently? They're poking out like a flipping pot roast.
Doing a lot of geocaching then?
Holy shit, I forgot that was even a thing.
You were always so focused on yourself. You never came to any of my ballet recitals.
I had a really bad experience with a swan once.
Also, you called me pork chop all the time.
That's like literally one of my top favorite types of chop.
You were a terrible boyfriend.
I'm glad I dumped you.
I never want to see you again.
Also, you were really messy and... Hey, cool amulet.
Don't touch that. If you touch that with somebody else, then you're gonna switch bodies or some shit. It's very dangerous.
Sorry.
Well... Okay, well, whatever. Seriously, here's Val to tell us about a story from her life that caused her some discomfort. Whatever. I'm gonna go for a walk or something.
All right, okay, so me and my boyfriend have broken up again. So I wanted to rebound, and I wanted to get, like, some ass. So me and this guy named Cam, he looked metro, but I like metro guys for some reason. I have a crush on them. You know, like, metro, like, look.
I can understand the appeal.
Okay, yeah, they're cute, right? And they got, like, a little, like... Look, they're not manly, but they're just like wispy, but they're really cute. Well, he was hot, and I really liked him. And I heard my friend, who I always date her ex-boyfriends, I heard that she dated him. So we kind of started our dating. What we really did was just started drinking together and partying every weekend. We drank at Jonas's house. I wasn't really friends with him, we were just hanging out. And me and Cam got really drunk together, and we were all so tanked, I couldn't even really walk. But whatever, he said to me, do you want to go home with me? And I was like, fuck yeah. I was ready to rebound. I wanted to rebound really bad. So I was like, fuck yeah, let's go home. So we go into his house. He started putting some weird kind of weird oil on my forehead. I don't know what he was doing. He was like a weird, natural, spiritual guy. So he started putting oil on my head, and I was like, okay. And then he kissed me. And I was like, cool, right on. Like, I'm gonna get laid. Start making out, and then he starts talking to me about how he likes to make out with guys. And he's like, actually, I've kissed a guy before. Do you think it's hot? And at the time I did, I thought like gay guys were hot. Like, you know, guys making out were hot together and shit. And then when he was kissing me though, I was like, that's it. That's like gross. But I was like, whatever, I wanna get laid. So whatever, I brushed it off. He still started talking to me though about like all the times he's made out with guys at parties. But that he had feelings for me, even though he liked guys. And I had no idea. So I was really shocked, but I was like, whatever, I'll go with it, you know? Gay guys kissing are hot. So I'm trying to get it on, but he can't get it up. I was getting really pissed off, so I was really drunk. And I said to him, what the fuck? Like, can you please get this up? Because I want to get laid right now. He looks at me and he says, you're fucking intimidating me. Like, can you stop it? I can't get enough of something like that. And I was like, you fucking kidding me? I was like, I'm 5 feet tall. You're intimidated by a 5 foot tall girl? And I was kind of starting to pissed off, made fun of, and I was like, can you please have sex with me right now? Like, I want to rebound, and I was getting all mad. And then he couldn't. So I was like, fuck this, whatever, I'm going to bed.